But regardless of that, as far as the entertainment value, what he brings to boxing, you know, he brings entertainment. It's not, it's, he's not aesthetically good to look at because he makes so many mistakes, but he keeps it exciting to an extent where you're going to bring some fans to go watch the fight because he'll make people so mad that you want to see him get knocked out.
Like Conor McGregor.
It's sad. Exactly. It's sad that we're in a day where that has to happen for people to really pay attention to what's going on with the heavyweight boxing.
Okay. So he's like Butterbean.
In a freak show. He's like, he brings more theatrics. His popularity is more due to his theatrics, but still he's getting in there and he's still legitimately beat.
Okay, my last question. Does Tyson Fury come back or that's it? We'll just talk about him in 5 years. There used to be a heavyweight.
That's not something I think any of us could answer. We can't speculate, especially at this point. I just find it ridiculously, not funny, but I just can't comprehend how someone wins 3 titles, finally is about to enter the biggest paydays of his life. I mean, fight after fight after fight, and after one win, just completely falls apart.
Yeah.
Of course, that's on Tyson Fury to answer. None of us can answer that for him.
Don't believe everything you hear in the media.
Another thing is
there's much more to the story.
Most people don't realize there's a lot of pressure at that point as well because it's not just, you know, he's got in boxing the title of, like, you know, all titles. It's the heavyweight champion of the world.
Most prestigious title in sports. Not only in boxing,
you know,
sports.
Not viewed as nowadays, but at a time, that was
the
most.
That was the title.
That was the title of all, like, athletes.
Yeah.
Heavyweight champion of the world. But, like, again, going back to Klitschko versus Anthony, that's a fight I'd like to see because I still want to see more of Anthony Joshua. You know what I mean? Because still, just for me, I think his level of opposition hasn't been as good. So when I'm watching him, I'm still seeing a lot of things that he's kind of allowing. Like, there's still a lot of holes I see that can be capitalized on with somebody that
so
goes
there's
to the
time that Klitschko has a shot is right now because in 6 months or a year.
But at the same token, it could be Anthony Joshua looking at it like, you know, the competition that I'm against isn't as up to par, so I want to see how he steps up against somebody that, you know, is actually
good. Let me tell you guys, Malik Scott was in camp with Klitschko and Anthony Joshua, and he told me more than once that Anthony Joshua did more than hold his own against Klitschko in sparring.
Yeah.
That he had a lot of success.
But see, that's
sparring is
Klitschko
entirely
does
different. Entirely different from the fight, though, because again, you look back at historically, Ali a lot of times held back in sparring. You know what I mean? You look at his sparring when he was getting ready to fight George Foreman, didn't look like he was doing much. You know what I mean? But again, nobody knew that he was actually in his mind developing a strategy. He's seeing things. And again, even like, you know, a lot of people, well, you know, you spar Pacquiao. Again, Pacquiao is still getting ready for a fight. So there's things that he's thinking, okay, I'm approaching this fight. How am I going to deal with this? How am I going to deal with that? So there's things that upper echelon of fighter is allowing to happen because they want to see, okay, how am I going to handle this if he brings this? You know what I mean?
So there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Sekpak reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter at Sekpak. And you can follow me on Instagram at Ellie Sekpak.